Hello friends, till now we have discussed the fixed biased circuits of BJT and self biased circuits. Now we will discuss the miscellaneous bias circuits of BJT. The very first circuit I will be talking about the bias voltage at emitter terminal. That means I have a circuit where biasing voltage is not connected at collector, rather it is connected at the emitter terminal. Like this, the collector is grounded and emitter terminal is connected a biasing voltage. Remember, for biasing of this circuit, the emitter terminal, if biasing voltage is given at collector, then it is positive voltage. And if biasing voltage is given at emitter, then it should be negative voltage, so that base to emitter junction is forward biased. Fine. Now, suppose this resistance is RB, this resistance is RE, this resistance is RC, this voltage from collector to emitter is VCE. Current entering at the terminal, collector terminal, is IC. This will be definitely collector terminal, and the terminal at which arrow is there, that is emitter terminal. This is the base terminal. This voltage between base and emitter is VBE. The current entering into the base terminal is IB. This is your BJT circuit with biasing voltage connected at emitter terminal. When biasing voltage is given at emitter terminal, the approach of analysis of the circuit remains same. The only change is the change of biasing voltage. Remember, in BJT circuits, there are hardly 2 to 3 types of questions. The first type of question could be, you may have to find the value of RB, RC or RE when you are given collector current and voltage VC or base current. So the signals may be given, you may have to find the value of resistances. That is one type of question. Second type of question can be, you may be given all the resistances of the circuit and gain of the transistor, and then you may have to locate the region of operation of the BJT, maybe saturation cutoff or active region. The third type of question can be, you may have to find the value of the collector current and voltage VC, that is the operating point or Q point. So hardly there are 2 to 3 types of questions on BJT. So instead of coming to the numerical directly, my aim is to let you know how to analyze the circuit. In BJT circuits, in most of the cases, the approach of analysis is, we apply KVL in the base circuit, get the base current, assume it in active region, then find IC by simply IC equal to beta IB, then apply KVL in the collector circuit. When you apply KVL in the collector circuit, you will be getting the voltage VC. So this is the approach with which we will be solving the circuit. Now, let us apply KVL in base circuit, and main thing is, you should know how to apply KVL in the circuit. Always start from one point, reach up to the next. So like this. So when you start from here, remember base current is moving in this direction. So this voltage drop, the terminal of the voltage drop will be plus, this will be minus. So I will be taking plus to minus voltage fall as negative. So RB into IB, that is voltage fall across this resistance, I will be moving in clockwise direction. Then come at this point, move from B to E. So plus to minus voltage fall. So I will be taking this as minus VBE. Then come here. What is the current here? This is IE. And you know what is IE? That is IB plus IC. So this voltage, again this will be plus. Remember, when current enters at the terminal of a resistance, that is positive, and the point at which current leaves is negative. So this is also plus to minus voltage fall in this direction. So minus IE, RE. And then this is minus. Remember, this negative sign can be assumed something like this, minus plus ground. this is minus VEE, right? So plus to minus, then minus VEE. So minus of this is what, voltage rise. So instead of writing minus VEE, I'll be writing it plus VEY, why? Because plus to minus voltage fall, I'll be moving in clockwise direction. So plus to minus voltage fall negative, plus to minus voltage fall negative, plus to minus voltage fall negative. Then that voltage minus VEE can be written like this, minus plus battery. So this is voltage rise, so plus VEE equal to 0. That is the KVL equation for base circuit. So we know IE is what? That is IB plus IC. So this gives minus RB IB minus VBE minus IB plus IC RE plus VEE equal to 0. Here this is the relationship for the base circuit, input circuit or base circuit, right? Now let BJT, here we will be going for assumption. What assumption? Remember, if it is this minus terminal is connected to negative terminal, base is connected to ground, so base to emitter junction must be forward biased. When base to emitter junction is forward biased, there is no question of cutoff operation of the BJT in cutoff region. Why? Because for cutoff region, both emitter and collector junctions must be reverse biased. So here emitter junction, this is emitter junction which is forward biased. So BJT is either in saturation or in active region. For active region, emitter junction is forward biased, collector junction is reverse biased. For saturation region, emitter junction and collector junctions both are forward biased. So here I will try to find whether your collector junction is forward biased or reverse biased, because emitter junction is definitely forward biased. So it is very clear from this polarity of this voltage, which is, this is NPN. N is connected to negative terminal, P base is connected to ground, so base to emitter voltage will be positive, VB will be positive, so this junction will be forward biased. So assumption here I will be carrying is, let BJT operates in active region. When BJT operates in active region, IC will be equal to what? Beta into IB. So if IC is equal to beta into IB, what will be this equation? This implies RB IB minus VBE minus 1 plus beta into IB into RE plus VEE will be equal to 0. That's what you have. Now this gives the base current IB equal to VEE minus VBE divided by, that is RB plus 1 plus beta into RE. This is your base current. So let this equation, this one, let this equation is first, let this equation is second, and let this equation is third, right? Now apply KVL in collector circuit. Why? Because what I have done, I have applied KVL in the base circuit, that is first. I have obtained collector current from the base current, I have obtained base current, I have obtained collector current from the base current, I can definitely get. So now apply KVL in the collector circuit. So when you apply KVL in the collector circuit, so what do we get? Start from the collector side, current from the collector will be entering from the collector. So in resistance it enters from this point, so this must be plus, and the point at which the current leaves the resistance, it is minus. So plus to minus is voltage fall. So I will be taking at negative, that as negative, so RC into IC. Then plus to minus voltage fall again, so minus VCE. Then again current is entering from here, so plus to minus, so that is nothing but, I will be writing it like IB plus IC directly instead of writing IE into RE, right? And then this is, I repeat it again, plus to minus, why? Because it is voltage drop across resistance, plus to minus VC, that is voltage fall, negative, then plus to minus, why? Because drop across resistance is again minus, and now minus to plus, that is voltage rise. So this has to be plus VEE equal to 0, right? So this is equation number 4, right? Now I can write the expression of VCE equal to what? That is RC IC plus IB plus IC into RE, right? And then this will be minus, this is minus and plus VEE. Why so? Because you can take VC, or you can take all the other things on right hand side, or you can change sign of VC. So you'll be getting this thing. Fine. Now you can replace IC by beta IB. So you will get VEE minus, what will be there? Beta IB into RC, or that is minus 1 plus beta RE into IB, or you can simply modify this equation like beta RC into IB, right? So now say this is equation number, you can say 5. Fine. Now what is VCB? Voltage VCB, voltage VCB is equal to VCE minus VBE. So there are two things to be observed here. I have to check whether base emitter junction is forward biased or reverse biased. When voltage VCE is less than VCE saturation, VCE set, this junction will be forward biased. And when voltage VCE is more than VCE set, this junction will be reverse biased, right? Or you can say when VCB is negative, VCB collector to base is negative. If VCB is negative, means this is minus, this is plus. Collector is what? N-type, base is P-type. If it is negative, it is positive. This will be forward biased. Why? Because N is negative, base is positive. So when VCB is negative, collector junction is forward biased. When VCB is positive, collector junction is reverse biased. So either you can conclude it from this or from this. This is your choice. No one is going to stop you from that analysis, right? So I repeat, when VCB is negative, collector junction is forward biased. When VCB is positive, collector junction is reverse biased. Number one. Number two, when VCE is greater than VCE set, VCE saturation voltage. I repeat, if VCE is greater than VCE set, and this is always given to you, that is nothing but in specification sheet, or if you talk about numerical, that is given to you, then remember, then BJT operates where? In active region. And when BJT operates in active region, then VCEQ, remember, then VCEQ and ICQ, VCEQ and ICQ are given by what? Given by VCEQ will be given by equation number 5, and IC will be given by beta into IB. That is equation number 2 respectively. That is first point. So after calculation of this voltage, if VCE, what is VCE set? VCE set is, remember, 0.2 volt for silicon and 0.1 volt for germanium. But that is given to you. If it is not given, you should remember this value. VCE saturation, so the value of VCE for saturation is 0.2 volt for silicon and 0.1 volt for germanium, right? Second point, if VCE is less than VCE set that is given to you, then BJT operates where? BJT operates in where? In saturation region, right? So when BJT operates in saturation region, remember, when BJT operates in saturation region, with VCE will be equal to VCE set. If calculated value of VCE is less than VCE set, freeze VCE at VCE set. Actually, VCE cannot fall below VCE set, that is our assumption. So I will be taking VCE equal to VCE set. Then ICQ will be given by what? ICQ can be calculated, calculated or obtained by using what? Can be obtained by using or solving equations, that is first and fifth, by taking VCE equal to VCE set. I will repeat the analysis. Understand it. When BJT, the when value calculated from this equation or this equation, VCE is more than VCE saturation voltage. VCE saturation voltage is given to you. That is in specification sheet. That is in your numerical. Or if it is not given, I told VCE saturation is 0.2 volt for silicon and 0.1 volt for germanium. If VCE calculated using this equation is more than VCE saturation, BJT operates in active region. When BJT operates in active region, this calculated value will be VCEQ, and this IC equal to beta IB, IB is obtained from here. So IC equal to beta IB will be giving you ICQ. Now, second point, if VCE is less than, if this calculated value of VCE is less than VCE saturation voltage, then BJT will be operating in saturation region. When BJT operates in saturation region, from this conclusion, then VCE will be fixed at VCE saturation. So the value of VCE at Q point will be equal to VCE saturation. So VCE saturation is obtained. Then IC can be calculated by using this equation and this equation, but VCE in this equation has to be replaced, or in this equation has to be replaced by VCE set. That is the simple analysis. Otherwise, we will see the questions. I will give you the solution of some questions which have appeared in different exam. But approach of analysis is important. You should know how to apply KVL in the base circuit. You should know how to relate collector and base circuit. Then you should know how to apply KVL in the collector circuit. If you are not comfortable with KVL, then you won't be able to handle questions in the exam. Point here is, you should be comfortable in applying the KVL in base and collector circuits, right? So this is the analysis with bias voltage at emitter. As such, till date no question has appeared from this circuit in exam, but you cannot avoid the possibility. Of course, there were questions on this type of analysis on PNP transistors in gate exam earlier, and maybe in engineering services also there may be possibility, right? But since there is, was no numerical directly on this type of circuit, so I won't be talking about numerical. In my next video, I'll be taking that bias voltage with emitter and collector. When you connect biasing voltage at emitter as well as collector, we will see how to analyze the circuit, and for that you need to wait for my next video. Thank you very much for watching the video.